SEO is a lot of work, and AI can help it be a lot less. Less work, better results, more revenue. Can't beat that. In this video, I'll be going over 6 different tactics you can use to improve your SEO with AI. Keep watching to find out more, and also be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell so you don't miss the latest digital marketing insights from our team. One thing AI tools can be really useful for is keyword research. Now, it's important to keep in mind that many AI tools don't have access to current data, so you shouldn't just generate a list and run with it. A great tactic is to provide a generative AI tool with an initial keyword you want to target, which would be your seed keyword. Then you just ask the tool to generate a list of keywords related to that seed. You can also clarify how long you want those keywords to be or any other specs you might have. When you get that initial list of keywords, you'll want to grab search volume and competitor data from a reliable SEO tool. That will give you a better idea of which keywords you should focus on and which may not be worth exploring more. So with a little bit of prompting and cross-checking, you can have a whole keyword targeting strategy laid out for you. Another good way to use AI is to help you generate content outlines. Let's say you're writing a blog post and you need to come up with an initial structure for it. You can use a tool like ChatGPT to help you do that. Just give it a prompt specifying what you want and include additional specs if you have any. Specs you might ask for include a specific style and tone, a particular word count, or even for ChatGPT to respond in the voice of a certain persona. Just a word of warning. Generating content outlines is fine, but I don't recommend using AI to write a whole unedited piece of content for you. At times, it may very confidently present you with false information, not giving any indication that the facts are made up. You obviously don't want to add false information to your website, so anything AI generated should be edited by a person. In addition to generating content outlines, AI can help you write much smaller pieces of text for your content. You can use AI to generate title tags and meta descriptions for the pages you're working on, making sure to include your target keyword. If you have a tool that can understand visual elements, you can also ask it to generate alt text for your images. Even with small pieces of text like these, you should still manually review them to make sure they work well for your content. Yet another thing generative AI can help you create is schema markup. If you don't know what schema markup is, it's basically a type of code that helps search engines understand more details about your pages. For example, Google might find a video on one of your pages. You can include schema markup to help clarify what the video is about, among other bits of information. You might feed your AI tool the text of a page or a link to your page, and then tell it to create the correct type of schema markup based on that information. Again, check the results to make sure what you get is the correct markup and not some jumble of code. You can plug the code or the URL with the code into schema.org's validator or Google's rich results test to make sure everything works as it should. I've mentioned already how you can use AI to help you write content, but you can also use it to help you revise, rewrite, or reoptimize existing content in a snap. Maybe you just want to fix potential tone, grammar, or spelling errors, so you put pieces of it through an AI tool to adjust all of that. A tool like Grammarly can help you find the right language for your audience, revising your content to fit your goals and tone, as well as checking for basic grammar issues. Maybe you have pages that aren't keyword optimized. You can feed them to an AI tool too, and ask for revisions that include your target keywords. Just make sure you read the results before you publish anything. You don't want a page that's so full of keywords it's hard to understand. You can even be specific and tell your AI tool how many times to include your keywords to make your life a bit easier. And if you want to change your content in more large-scale ways, you might put the whole thing through a generative AI tool and ask it to completely rewrite what's already there according to a specific set of parameters. Be sure to specify things like style and length and edit manually before you publish. Finally, you can use AI tools to help you analyze your SEO data. There are a lot of analytics tools like GA4 or your favorite customer relationship CRM platforms that use machine learning in their data analysis. Some tools will let you speak with them to glean insights from all your data. Other tools can help you create formulas that make analyzing in a spreadsheet a breeze. It's definitely a lot faster to let AI help you with these analytics tasks than trying to perform them entirely on your own. Don't be afraid of integrating AI into your SEO analytics strategy. It'll save you so much time and give you new insights that can take your campaigns to the next level. And now you know how you can use AI to improve your SEO strategy. You have lots of options when it comes to choosing your tools. Some tools are straight up generative AI platforms like ChatGPT, Claude, or Gemini. Others are add-on features to an existing SEO tool like GA4 or SEMrush. Whatever tools you choose, the key is using them in a way that benefits your SEO and gets you ranking higher in the search results. Hey, by the way, if you want to see more helpful SEO videos like this, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We've got lots of useful marketing content here. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.